Hey, welcome back to the MyGo YouTube channel. Got an interesting, highly requested test in for you today. This is an AC driverless Samsung LM301B board. Found on AliExpress. Took about 6 or 7 weeks to come through, so I've been waiting for it patiently. And put it up for test today. Gonna see how it does. Will it compete with the full driver versions by the likes of Chilled and Groma and HLVG and all those sort of guys? Well, we're gonna find out. Quick overview of it first. It's a round SMD single mount device board. So it's got multiple, the Samsung LM301B diodes on it. It's got then the special feature, mounted of course on a pin fin heatsink on the back. Oh, and you also get this acrylic cover for it too, acrylic lens. Not the highest quality looking optical device, but we did try it on, see how it worked. And we tested it. But yeah, it's a fairly basic thing. Pin fin heatsink is nice enough. It's got lots of unnecessary holes in it, so it's sort of a generic thing. I think it's been used for lots of different models. Not all the screws were tapped right, so I could only get 3 screws in on this version. I could have drilled it out and re-tapped, but I wasn't bothered just for a relatively short test. Yeah, 220 volts, so I just got a mains cable to plug straight into the mains there. It comes through the back, you can see there, it comes through the back, in through the front, and in through those push type terminals on the front. And yeah, so it's screw the board onto the heatsink, push in the wires to connect it up, and we're ready to go. There you go, nice and bright. Specified as 100 watts, at 240 volts, it consumes 106 watts. We hung it up in the 2 foot by 2 foot grow area with silver mylar walls, optimized it from height to 20 centimeters height. Again, getting the center measurement, the highest measurement, less than 1000 PPFD. And we did the usual, we did the 16 measurements across the grow area to get the average PPFD across the grow area, multiply it by the area to get the total amount of PPFD. We did this both with the cover on and the cover off. We're gonna go with the cover off version because that's what we have been comparing since our HLG controversy. That's what we have been comparing for efficiency for this type of device. We have the general Samsung LM301B combinations with Meanwell drivers. We've tested 3 of them so far. Four of those combinations so far. And they sort of ranged from maybe 2.05 up to 2.15, nearly 2.2. Any difference is this, if the chips are what they say they are, which is Samsung, will be down to driver efficiency. This driver is a flip-flop driver, basically means it's relatively low-tech and quite simple, and also unfortunately low efficiency, and you get flicker. So you wouldn't be using this for filming or any sort of fancy stuff with human lighting, but for plants they don't care. The light is flickering on and off, why would they care? But it does affect the efficiency dramatically. So where we've had above 2 for lots of other versions of this lights, this unfortunately is a 1.49 with the cover off, best result. With the cover on or the lens on, it delivers a 1.38. The spread of light is no better cover on or off. So I would go with cover off from efficiency. It's gonna help with heat dissipation. just on that, because the driver is mounted on the board with the lighting, it's generating a lot of heat. It's obviously not very efficient. It's sort of maybe 70% efficient, 65-70% efficient. And I'm going to measure it later, but I have to damage the board to do it, so I didn't want to do it today. So yeah, it's about 70% efficient, which is pretty low, generating quite a lot of heat. So, you know, this pin fin heatsink is definitely required, and you probably should be putting, but you should be putting some thermal paste in between the board and the heatsink just to get that heat away from the driver as fast as possible. I looked at the operating temperature, surface temperature of the chips on the board, and they're okay. They're running at about 60 to 70 degrees centigrade in a room about 20 degrees warm. So they're running about 50 degrees over ambient, which is not bad. I didn't look up the specs for the chips themselves to see what they could tolerate, but for electronics, that's not a hugely high temperature. So yeah, an interesting format. The limitation with this really is the driver. So the fact that you've got this low cost, small component driver fitted onto the board, it's very convenient, but you lose a whole load of efficiency, pretty much a quarter of the efficiency, over a quarter, 30% of the efficiency lost due to that convenience. Yeah, interesting to hear what you think about these ones. Link is in the description below. I haven't put the price here because you'll all argue with me, just tell me you get it somewhere else cheaper and da 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 da. So let you comment on the pricing yourself, where you find it, and whether you think it's good value or money or not, when you add in all the delivery fees, import duties, import taxes, etc, etc. So yeah, interesting little board, nice to test. Look forward to your comments. Take care, bye.